be totally relaxed. Your head is going to fall forward with your chin to your chest. It's never going to fall backwards. It's going to fall forward with your chin to your chest. Those muscles are going to be completely relaxed. And that's on 1, 2, 3. Chin to your chest. That's right. Feel that relaxation just wash over you. And feel that relaxing sensation that started in the back of your neck. It's going to start to spread down towards your shoulders. Your shoulders are going to become incredibly relaxed. Your arms are going to become incredibly relaxed. And the rest of your body just feels that relaxing sensation with your chin to your chest. Now, as that's, you'll always move slowly and lightly with full control on your mind. You'll always be very safe. If you want to get into a different position, feel free to open your eyes and make sure you're going to be in a safer and more comfortable position across the chairs or across the floor, and you can do that anytime you like. It's very important that you're as relaxed and comfortable as you can possibly be. Make sure you're taking those deep breaths in and exhale, and just feel that relaxing sensation all through your body. Right now, I want you to imagine the most comfortable position you can think of. It might be stretched out across the floor in front of you. It might be in a different position on the chair. But I want you to imagine that position that you're imagining. Your body's going to be totally comfortable. I'm going to count to three, and I want you to get in that position. You can move slowly and lightly with full control on your mind when I count to three. If you need to open your eyes and look around while you're moving, you can do that too. And on the count of three, that's on 1, 2, 3. Go ahead and find that position. If you want to slither down to the floor, you can do that. That's it. Just move real slow. That's it. If you feel any movement or somebody around you moves or touches you, that's okay. If you hear any sounds in the audience, that's all right. That is going to make you go even deeper and get you even more focused and comfortable. That's it. Any sounds around you are going to make you go even deeper. And make sure you still breathe. I'm going to count down from 5. And when we get to 0, your body is going to be 10 times as comfortable as it is right now. If you're in a comfortable position, great. When I get to 0, and as I'm counting down, if you need to move, you can do that too. And that's on 5, relaxing every muscle. 4, feeling that relaxing sensation continue to surge through your body. 3, relaxing every muscle, every nerve. 2, 1, 0. 10 times as comfortable. Your body is totally relaxed. Your focus is continuing to go even. You're going to hear a big applause when I count to 3, and that's going to make your relaxing sensations grow even further. All right, I'm going to count 3, 1, 2. Wide awake on 3. Wake up, everybody. Wake up. Go ahead and open your eyes. That's it. You can sit up now if you're on the floor. Go ahead and open your eyes. Sit on up for me. You can find a chair that you were in. You can find a chair and grab a seat. Very good. Let's give them one more round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. They are doing great. Excellent. Okay. All right. We're going to bring it right back here, everybody. Wide awake, feeling totally energized. I want you to focus on my hand. Take a deep breath in. And exhale. Slowly and comfortably with full control on your mind. Sleep! That's it. Find that comfortable position. That's it. Find that relaxation and peace within your body. You feel that relaxation all around you. Your body's totally comfortable, totally relaxed. All right. So, with your eyes closed, I want you to remain awake and focused on my voice. I'm sitting in a beach chair in the Bahamas. Yeah, feel the sunshine on your face. Oh yeah, check it out. Lean back and just check out this perfect 80 degree weather in the Bahamas sunlight. If you want to get on the floor and stretch out like you got a beach towel, you can do that. If the chair's not quite comfortable, you can totally and just soak in this beautiful sunshine. There's some exotic birds flying overhead. Lean back. Check out these birds flying overhead. Oh my gosh, this is so good. This is a well-deserved vacation. It has been a long school year, and you deserve to be here. So let's set the stage. And let me describe where you are. If you look to your right, you can see fields, rolling hills, just stretching as far as you can see. It's almost like out of a picture on the wall. If you look to your left, you can see white sand beaches stretched as long as you can see. Now, we are sitting next to a pool, but if you look behind you, go ahead, sit up and look behind you, you can see the turquoise water of the ocean. It is the most beautiful thing you have ever seen. And, oh wait, holy cow, there's somebody that you know that's walking on the beach. You wait for them, get their attention. How is this possible? Somebody you know, yell to them. Get their attention. Are you kidding me? They're here. Maybe they didn't hear you. Okay, all right, let's turn our attention back to the pool here. Back to the pool. And just get totally relaxed. And I want to describe to you what's going on right now. Just lean back, relax, enjoy the sunlight and the sunshine. Perfect 80-degree weather. Now, I want you all to know, you are feeling good. But one of the reasons why you are feeling good is because you look good. You have been working out 3 hours a day, every day for the last 6 months. You are looking the best you've ever looked in your life, and you are not afraid to show it. You are sitting poolside. Absolutely. You are feeling good. Absolutely. Now, you are sitting next to a beautiful pool. It's got a swim-up bar. This is a 5-star resort. It's got everything you could possibly want. There's parasailing, hand gliding, water skiing, ATV riding, anything you want to eat or drink at your disposal. Now let me describe the scenery a little bit. If you're interested at all, there are some good-looking gentlemen roaming around this pool. Oh my gosh. Looks like these guys have been working out as well. Oh my gosh, these guys are like glowing in the sun. Incredible. Now, if you're interested at all, there's some good looking ladies around here as well. Yeah. There was a rumor that Sports Illustrated was having their swimsuit shoot. Those ladies could definitely be some of these models. I don't even know how you call some of these bikini swimsuits. I mean, incredible. And oh my gosh, look over there. There are two women that are obviously, they're not a part of our group, but they've chosen to sunbathe with their tops off. Holy cow. Wow. Oh my God. So let's focus on the pool in front of you. Focus on the pool in front of you. Soak in that 80-degree weather, that sunlight. Again, there's some exotic birds flying overhead. You are just feeling great. And I want you to land down on a beach towel or something. You can do that. If you're cool in your beach chair, that's fine as well. Now, you are loving this vacation the most you've ever loved any vacation in your life. But because you're feeling so good, you haven't been paying attention to the news. See, the Bahamas is about to get hit by a heat wave. Something they haven't seen in 20 years. But you don't notice at first because right now, it's just a perfect 80 degrees. Then it goes up to about 85 degrees. You barely notice the difference. Maybe a little hotter, but it gets up to 90 degrees. Starting to feel a little warmer. Humidity kicks in a little bit. 95 degrees. A couple beads of sweat develop on your forehead. You're definitely feeling that heat. That humidity's really kicking in at 100 degrees. You start feeling that sweat on your upper lip, you know, you're sweating, you can wipe that off if you want to, yeah. Just, man, you start to get sweaty. That heat is kicking in. Now we're gonna keep our clothes on, but you can definitely feel the heat because it's going up. At 105, you are legitimately sweating now. This is just not comfortable. You did not sign up for this. At 110 degrees, you know what's really crazy? Your feet feel like they're on fire. Your feet feel like they're on fire. You got shoes on. You need to kick those shoes off. Get those shoes off. Your feet are on fire. It gets up to 115 degrees. Man, it's almost hard to breathe. It gets up to 120 degrees. Who wants some water? If you want some water, sit up and put your hand out. I'm going to give you a drink of water. Before you drink it, visualize that cup of water floating in towards you. It's a beautiful cup of water. Eyes, it's got the condensation running down. It's so refreshing. Go ahead and grab it. Take a sip right now. Start drinking. Oh, I'm sorry. I gave you vinegar. That's not water. Spit that out. Oh, my gosh. I'm so sorry. Next to your foot, there's a glass of water. Pick up that water. That's it. Just wash it down. Feel that refreshing cold water. Relax. And that temperature is coming down, back down to a perfect 80 degrees. Right back to paradise in the Bahamas. Oh, yeah. If you hear any sounds around you, feel anybody touching you, right, that's okay. That's going to make you focus even further, get totally relaxed, totally comfortable. If you're holding your water, you can set it down. Now, usually these things come in twos. And they had the cold, they had the heat wave. I'd like you to remain focused on my voice with your eyes closed on the stage. I gotta realize, anytime I say the word ouch, and only when I say ouch, you are going to feel the hardest, most painful pinch on your rear end that you have ever felt. And you are not gonna be happy, because that's your place. That's your special place, and somebody just pinched it. You're gonna be angry, you're gonna accuse the person next to you, and that's when I say ouch, and only when I say ouch after we wake up. Also, whenever you hear me say the word cookies, I want you to picture walking into the kitchen when you were a kid, Mom's baking cookies, it's a snow day, and you just feel so good. It's the best smell you've ever smelled. That's when I say cookies, only when I say cookies. You're gonna smell that smell, and you're gonna wanna find that smell. It might be coming from somebody next to you, like their neck area or something. They might be under the chairs. We're not gonna lift up the chairs, but it's gonna be around the stage, and you're gonna wanna find that smell. But on the opposite end, anytime you hear me say the word beans, and only when I say the word beans, you are gonna smell the most repulsive, repugnant, disgusting smell you can possibly smell. It might be coming from the person next to you, it's coming from somewhere, and you've gotta get away from it. You're not gonna run, you might need to crawl around, but you're gonna wanna get away from it. That's only when I say, that's when I say beans, is only when I say beans. I'm gonna have you wake up on the count of three, your eyes are gonna open, you're gonna feel totally refreshed, totally energized. You're gonna hear a big applause, and that's gonna make your relaxation grow even further. And that's on one, two, three. Go ahead and wake up. Give them a hand, everybody. Open your eyes. Go ahead and sit up. All right. Now, if you look around, we had some people take their shoes off. You see your shoes? I want you to push them out toward the audience. We'll just clear those out of the way. And after you do that, you can have a seat. That's it. Very good. Feeling totally relaxed, totally comfortable. Go ahead and remove these shoes and socks out of the way. Go ahead and find a seat, chair. Good. All right. Now, you guys, I just want you to remember, you're doing a great job up here, feeling fantastic. Safety is my number one priority. Safety is absolutely number one. I'm not gonna have you do anything that's gonna hurt yourselves. And I don't need to do anything that is going to hurt you. Because when you get hurt, you know what you say? You say, ouch. You just say, oh, what's going on here? What just happened? She pinched me. Where'd she pinch you? Right here. Yeah? Yeah? What's
What's going on here? What happened to you?
Pinched my butt.
We want to keep this show, but you just relax. You have a seat right there, bud. What happened down here? What happened to you? You hurt? Where do you hurt? What? Are you okay right here, buddy? What happened? Who do you think did? We good down here? You look a little upset. What happened to you?
Pinch me.
No way. Where'd she pinch you?
In the butt.
All right. If you got pinched in your butt, maybe by somebody sitting next to you, we don't want that to happen again. We want a nice, safe show. So go ahead and change seats. Just get away from that person right now, everybody. Get away from that person. Go ahead. All right. Let's relax. You good? Same thing happened. What happened?
She's the last girl.
What did you say?
All right, let's relax.
What did you say?
Right, have a seat.
Ask the girl.
Have a seat, everybody. Have a seat. And just relax. We want to be safe. Now, I'm always really impressed when I come to this lock-in. I was here last year. You guys always have, like, the best facility. This is a gorgeous facility. You guys have got all kinds of snacks and drinks and, like, cookies and just... You got cookies that are, man, just I have heard that these cookies are amazing. Can you guys smell that?
Is it amazing?
Now it's good. It's good because I wouldn't want them to serve beans. That would be bad. I do not want them. I'm glad they're not serving beans. That would be horrible. Horrible. Yeah. I much prefer cookies. Yeah, cookies. Cookies are much better. Oh man, there's. Oh yeah, cookies. Okay. So just relax, find a seat, those smells are gone. And just take a deep breath and exhale. Go ahead and just let your eyes shut, but don't make me focus on my voice. And I'd like you to realize that when I have you open your eyes in a second, I'm going to explain to you that I am holding a sleep gun. Now, this sleep gun is amazing. Special bullets that I have in it make me feel like 100 times better than you are right now. And you're feeling pretty good right now. There's just like waves of euphoria that are going to go through you. And you want to get shot by the sleep gun. When you get shot by the sleep gun, you're gonna sleep in less than a second. You're gonna move to a comfortable position. You're not gonna get hurt, you're not gonna fall over a chair, you're not gonna push or land on anybody. You're gonna be very safe, you can use your arms to guide you, but you are gonna sleep in less than a second. You're gonna feel completely relaxed and comfortable. And you definitely want to get shot by the sleep gun. So, on a count of three, you're gonna open your eyes and I'm explaining exactly what I have. One, two, three. Open your eyes, everybody. I have a surprise for you. I don't do this in every show, but this was special. It's an after prom. I recently picked up, got qualified here, a sleep gun right here. And you guys have heard of this, I can tell. Who wants to get shot by the sleep gun? Oh my gosh, a lot of people want to get shot. Okay, very good. So how about you? Right there. Oh yeah. Anytime you hear me say, point it right at you to sleep in less than a second. Out. Extra easy, that's it. We're gonna move, make sure move slowly, comfortably. Oh, a lot of people are going crazy here.
Look at Bree, she's like, what is going on?
Good. How about we go behind the back here? That's good. All right, good. Yes, right there, and right there. Easy. Let me switch it to automatic. Excellent, just nailed. Yes, okay, very easy. Oh, they're pretty eager. Let's see if I can get two birds with one stone here. And then I go, two guys, there you go. Really easy. Awesome. Let's see. Oh. everybody. Yeah. And then, oh, sorry. What's your name?
Noah.
I guess I know. Can you put your hand up? Stand up for me. Come here. He's down here. Right, no, he's down right here. No, so I want in on this too. So before we can take care of you, we're gonna take care of me. I'm gonna hand the gun to you. I'm gonna count to three, and you're gonna shoot me because I want to feel it, and then you can use it on you. Is that cool? Oh no, yeah, it's okay. Trust me, it's gonna feel even better when you shoot yourself after you shoot me. I promise. Okay. And so here you go. You put your hand out. Put your hand in the shape of the gun. Are you left or right hand? Right hand. Okay. Well, you can speak. It's totally cool. You don't have to speak. Put it in your right hand. Or your left, it doesn't matter. And square up your body so you get a good shot at me, okay? That's it. Oh man, I'm getting ready to feel this. So I'm gonna count to three, all right? One, two, three. Oh, hang on. Yeah, with rookies, it's a little bit tricky. Just make sure. That's okay. It's just gonna be one shot. Yeah, maybe your aim was a little off. That's okay. Maybe my fault. It's like, what, 4 a.m? It's crazy, okay? Let's try it again. Now, are you ready? One, two, three. Hang on. Maybe Jim, would you take a look inside there? Easy. Okay. Let's hear it for Noah, everybody. You like that? I'm ready to nod your head. You can feel it. Listen. Good. I'm going to touch your head right now. I'm erasing the number 6 from your head right now. Number 6 is gone. It doesn't exist. That's impossible. Even if somebody says it, you won't know what that is. When we have you count to the number 6, you're going to skip it. You're going to count to 10, and you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. If we have you count by 2, you're going to go 2, 4, 8, 10, 12. The number 6 is gone out of this person's head. This person right here, you can go ahead and nod your head if you can feel me. Whenever we say the word Tarzan, you are going to stand up, give us your best Tarzan bell, while you're beating your chest as loud as you can, and then you're going to blame them. And that's all. 1, 2, 3. Wake up, everybody. Wake up, everybody. Go ahead and sit on up. Yeah, wake up. Feeling good. There you go. If you want to have a seat in the chair, you can. If you're cool on the floor, that's cool too. You know, when I go to these places, a lot of chairs, sometimes they're folding chairs, sometimes they're yellow chairs. These chairs are red. But they seem to be working okay. I don't know. Oh, hi. What's your name? JC? Can I help? Did you have to say something to them? You want to announce something? Yeah? Okay. Well, hang on. Take the mic. Okay. It'll come back to you. Go ahead and see. Yeah, just go over here. I think you had an announcement or something. It was like pretty urgent. Okay, good. Now, you guys got a lot of activities here. What do they call the inflatable balls that you guys, the killer ball? They had before. Not at all. Yeah, that was so much fun. I hear that after this, they're going to screen a movie. Actually, I think they're going to show Tarzan or something.
Ah!
No? Good? Okay. Look, we can't have interruptions like that, all right? You guys, so just have a seat. Have a seat. Relax. What's your name? Hi, Mom. Nice to meet you. Can you stand up for a second? Come on up here. Awesome, Molly. Okay, good. You're a pretty smart girl. You're okay at school. Good. You put 2 hands out like this. So here's what's gonna happen. Oh, nice nails. Very good. We're gonna count the fingers on your left hand. I start at your pinky, and we're gonna go to your thumb. Put the microphone right in front of your face. You're gonna speak loud and clear. What was your name again? Okay, so here we go. 1, 2, 3. Excellent. Now we're going to count the fingers on your right hand. We're going to go from your thumb to your pinky. And over the microphone, you just speak loud and clear, Molly. Here we go.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
You have 11 fingers. That's pretty cool. We better count again, just make sure. We count from this pinky all the way over here. Go ahead.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
That is fascinating. Wow, not many people have 11 fingers. Give her a hand. Have a seat. We'll come back to you later. Okay. Who likes money? You guys like money?
Yeah.
Who would like, if I brought some money to give out tonight, would you like that? Would that be pretty cool? Okay. So, TV is going around this $1 million giveaway. It is called the $1 million Dance Contest. So they are going to judge the best dancer. And the best dancer is going to win $1 million tonight in a suitcase cash. And what we want you to do, go ahead and stand up, and you need to get loose right now. Okay? Go ahead and get loose. That's it. Stretch out those muscles. Stretch out those legs and arms. And get ready to impress the judges. Because this is going to be amazing. You're going to hear some incredible applause as we go along. You guys got to show us that you are ready to win $1 million. Most of you guys ready for the dance contest? Listen to that thunderous applause. Are you guys ready? All right, here we go. Uh-oh, yeah, that's it. Who's going to win the dance contest? Uh-oh. Nice. A lot of good dancers here tonight. I don't know. This is going to be a tough call. Let's bring away back a little creative. Yeah. Anybody want to push a shopping cart? Can you push a shopping cart? Yeah. Get your groceries, put them in the basket, put them in the basket. That's it. You're in the cereal aisle. Get your Lucky Charms, your Fruit Loops, your Fruity Pebbles. And you want to eat healthy, so get your sugarless cereal on the bottom shelf. There you go. Your Cheerios, Rice Krispies, Grape Nuts, that's it. Go ahead and drive back on the home. Only it's not a car, it's a bus. Drive the bus. That's it. Make that big left turn. Alright. Now while you forgot some groceries, you forgot some milk. Why don't you milk the cow? Milk the cow! Milk the cow! Get some milk! Yeah! Wow. Some serious milkers going on here. Good. How about you churn the butter? Churn the butter, you know what I mean? That's it. Churn the butter. Let's do a little yard work. Get out your lawnmower. Try and start it up. Start up the lawnmower. That's it. That's it. This lawnmower is just not starting. You gotta give it a kick. Don't kick anybody else. Kick that lawnmower. Push it along and start it up. Oh, grass. Not to be confused with the shopping cart. Oh, yeah. All right. Wave to your neighbors. Your neighbor's outside. What's happening? Back it up. Make sure nobody's toes get run over. And we got the grass cut. We got to get it growing again. Put one hand behind your head. Put your other hand up and give me the sprinkler. Oh, yeah. Bring it back. Or put your hands up like an old school sprinkler. Wave your fingers. Oh man, that is just excellent. Oh, find a seat as we relax. Just find a seat, and we are gonna just see what the judges say. What the judges say here. That was, man, that was some contest. Let's give them a big hand again. Did they do an incredible job? Oh, gosh, you know what? Judges, absolutely. The judges are pretty certain in their decision here. Let's see. What's your name right here, old guys? What's your name? Cannon, stand up for me. Stand up, Cannon. You think you did a pretty good job? You guys can open your eyes. Check it out. Kanan is the winner of $1 million. Kanan, give me five, buddy. Yeah. So what do you think? Tell me, do you think you were better than everybody?
Definitely.
Yeah. Do you think the rest of these guys are just, tell me how I think they're terrible. Do you want to point out anybody you think was like really a couple people?
That guy. Yeah.
What do you guys think? Wasn't Kanan awesome? What are you going to do with your $1 million?
I'm going to buy a sports car.
My sports car. That's awesome. Okay, turn around. Take a, ladies and gentlemen. Wait. Getting a message here. Wait a minute. You can't do that. I already told. No. Wait. Karen, I'm really sorry. Was it? Like, we got the wrong person. I'm sorry. Have a seat. It wasn't, what's your name? You are actually the winner of $1 million! No! Incredible, are you guys excited? No, you're not. Joe, what are you gonna get $1 million?
Oh, buy a better sports car.
Oh, man. Oh, hang on a second. Wait, what is this? No, you cannot, you guys can't do this. You've never done this before. Are you serious? Two, three. 3. Guys, go ahead and open your eyes and wake up and find a seat. I have something I need to share with you. Go ahead and just find a chair. Yeah, find a chair anywhere. And I am so sorry to share this with you, but this has never happened to me before, so it's really hard to say. I mean, this is what I do for a living, I'm a professional, but things just didn't work out tonight. I was really excited to come to your lock-in here. I've tried everything. You guys have been up here for an hour, and just nothing has clicked. What? You seem really upset.
Well, why am I spending money on you if you're not helping out our game?
You're right. I'm so sorry, you guys. What did you say? You're absolutely right. What did you say? Yeah. Somebody say something about me? Yeah, say that one more time.
How can you call yourself a hit?
I am so sorry, guys. I wanted people to be safe. I didn't want anybody to get hurt or say ouch. What? Hey, we okay? We all right? I thought somebody had some cookies somewhere or something. I don't know. Yeah.
I mean,
they put the cookies all around the stage, and I had specifically ordered beans. I had to order beans, and they didn't even listen. I mean, I was like, no, they need cookies. You gotta have cookies. Yeah, absolutely. They're gonna have cookies, and they're gonna be walking around, they're gonna be sitting in their chairs, which are red. The chairs are red. That's where everybody's sitting. Oh, hi again. Okay, good, that's all right. I mean, we gotta get this hypno in, we gotta adhere to the schedule. You guys are gonna go home, you're gonna watch Tarzan. No, again? Oh, we're trying to do the show here. Is it okay? No, please, no more interruptions. Okay, thank you. No more interruptions right here. Just have a seat. Okay, thank you. Yes, guys. Let's see, was there a Molly again? Was there a Molly? Molly, come on up here real quick. How you doing? Feel good? You put your hands together like this, your fingers together, maybe put them out like this. We're gonna count by twos. I'm gonna start making a pinky ring on twos. But it's a good lightning! It's a lightning of euphoria and adrenaline. It's gonna make you feel like you just woke up from the deepest, most refreshing 8-hour sleep you've ever felt. You're gonna be wide awake, you're gonna be completely energized. When you get struck by that lightning as soon as you wake up, you're gonna jump up as high as you can. And as soon as your feet touch the floor, the trance is gonna be broken and you'll be no longer hypnotized. You will immediately come out of it. You will no longer respond to any responses. You're gonna remember the number 6. The words Tarzan isn't gonna mean anything. The words cookies or beans isn't gonna mean anything. And you will come completely back to normal. You may remember everything, but you may not. It may seem like a distant dream, like when you wake up where everything is on the tip of your tongue, but you can't really remember it. But you'll come completely out of it. You're going to feel totally energized, totally relaxed. That's when I count to 3 and say, wake up. You're going to immediately jump up as high as you can while you're getting struck by lightning. And you're going to be completely awake. Now, before we wake you up, I want you to focus on my voice. This is for the people on stage as well as in the audience. All right, so a lot of you are seniors, some of you are juniors. I think there's some sophomores and freshmen here as well. For the last hour, my voice in the count of 3, you're going to wake up. You are going to hear the most thunderous applause you've ever heard. It's going to create even more good feelings as that lightning's going to strike. You're going to jump up, and as soon as your feet hit the floor, you're going to come out of it. Everything is going to go back to normal. You're going to feel totally energized. You all ready? Bushnell, on the count of 3, 1, 2, 3, wake up! Everybody.